Hello everyone, welcome to Smart Vision. I believe more and more people have already tried Sora 2. I haven't played it yet. I'm sorry. Many of you have thoughts about the Sora 2 video watermark and want to remove it. At the same time, you want to make it higher definition and higher quality, even reach 4K. This episode will definitely meet your need, because the method provided here is not only simple to operate, but also requires only 8GB of VRAM. Very practical. Hello everyone, welcome to Smart Vision. This channel focuses on practical, locally runnable AI knowledge and workflows that can help you make money. If you enjoy my videos, please like, share, and subscribe. Your support is my greatest motivation to keep creating. For more downloadable examples and useful workflows, follow my Patreon. Now, let's begin today's episode. The method I bring you today can not only remove the Sora 2 watermark, but also remove any form of watermark. The idea and approach are very simple. First, we need to install ComfyUI. Open the official website, choose the version that fits your PC here, and click to download. After the download is complete, install it. After installation, open it and you will see an interface like this. Then drag the workflow I provide into ComfyUI. You will see an interface like this. You will see 5 modules here. The setting module, the load data module, the remove watermark module, the upscale module, and the final combination module. The first module is setting. There are 4 places to configure here. Tile size, this sets the tile size for VAE encode and decode to reduce VRAM usage. The larger the value, the more VRAM is consumed. I set it to 5 out of 12, which basically satisfies low VRAM needs. If you have less than 8GB ever VRAM, you can choose a lower value, such as 256. Next is the model chosen for upscale. I use Real Web Photo for real heaven scene videos. If you want to process animation videos, you can choose other models such as Ultra Sharp. Here you fill in the folder path to save the images of the video after watermark removal. Here you fill in the folder path to save the images after upscaling. The second module is Load Data. This contains a number counter that code for reading video. First, we need to choose the video. After selecting it, this will display how many images, frames the video contains in total. If it does not show, set it to 0 and it will appear. We write this number into the number counter's stop position. And set this to 1, meaning read 1 image at a time to avoid running out of memory. If you have a lot of memory, you can set it to 2, 4, etc. and make the same change here. These 2 nodes mean that each time ComfyUI runs once, this number will increase by 1. After multiple runs, the video will be processed frame by frame without exhausting memory. Note that the number counter increments each time it runs. If you want to restart processing the video, reload the number counter. Now we look at the core module of this episode, remove watermark. I actually tried several methods, including using models like Florence 2 or Sound 2 to detect watermark location. Then repainting the watermark areas with stable diffusion nodes like Diffue Eraser. But I found the results unsatisfactory, and Diffue Eraser in particular would freeze on each run for unknown reasons. Then I had a sudden idea, why not use an image edit model, such as Quen Image Edit 2506, and directly write a few prompts to remove the watermark. Simple and blunt, and the quality is very good. But Quen Image Edit 2506 runs too slowly and isn't very practical. Then I thought of Tia Cache, an inference accelerator for diffusion models. This accelerator currently only supports the Flux Context Image Edit model, so I decided to use Flux Context. Here I directly link the Tia Cache node. The prompts here say to remove the watermark and the text Sorina. For KSamper, I set steps to 2. If you want it faster, you can choose 1, but the result may not be as good. Because this just removes the watermark on the existing image, rather than generating a new image. 2 is enough. Of course, the more steps, the better the effect. After removing the watermark, we enter the upscale module. This module will enlarge the image by 4 times, so a 1080p image will become 4K. First, it gets the image height and width to calculate the enlarged dimensions. The image is first upscaled 2 times by an upscale model, and then detail enhancement is performed. Here we load a model used to add image detail during upscaling. I used FluxDev because Tcache supports it, which can increase speed. Here we load a clip model to understand the prompts. Both VAE encode and decode use tiled mode. For Ksamper, I set steps to 20 and denoise to 0.25. The purpose is to avoid the image changing too much so that adjacent frames remain coherent. After adding details is upscaled another 2x with the upscale model. Finally, the images are saved. You can also use many other models. Refer to my video for more. 4K upscaling is very time consuming, so keep that in mind. After enlarging all the images, finally convert them back to video. In this module, choose the original video to read FPS and audio, then combine into a video. When operating, first fill in setting, then open these 2 modules. Check how many frames the video has, and after checking, write that number here. Also run these nodes with that number. At first, ComfyUI limits the maximum to 100, so we need to change that in the settings here. Then click Run, and wait for it to finish. Because 4K upscaling is very time-consuming, if you only want to remove the watermark, you can disable this module. Finally, close those 2 modules, open this final combination module, and run it once to do the final merge. Thanks for watching. Please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share my channel. All resources can be found on my Patreon. See you next time.